got this VeePeak OBD reader on eBay. Got it for like 40 bucks or something. So plugs right into your OBD port. And you gotta download an app to use with this. It's called the OBD Fusion. You could download that in the iTunes store. I got this today because I want to check the overflow on my transmission. I believe it's kind of low, so.
OBD port.
We're gonna break this loose today, that's the fill. Here's the drain. We're not gonna do anything today because we're just checking the overflow. That's the overflow. It's a little bump that goes up. And let's get started.
Ow! Duplex.
VeePeak connect. OBD Fusion. Connect. Connect it. Here's my temperature with while it's sitting, it's like 85 degrees in my garage. So now we're gonna fire it up. We'll get this thing to about 100 degrees on the ATF pan. Waiting for that 100, there we go. Yep, so I was right. I was low on transmission fluid, so I did it off camera. It was a messy job. And it was so hot under there. I just had to fill it up, do it quick, and pretty much you gotta pump transmission through that fill port line, and you pump until it comes out to the overflow, and then you kind of plug it up once you get it up to temperature. But I'm going to show you how to set up the OBD app Fusion. I'm going to go into settings, users, define PIDs. I already have this set up. I got my ATF pan and my torque converter. And pretty much you just want to go to menu, go to new. And this is where I'm gonna give you some codes to enter in so you can create your ATF pan and your torque converter. Let me delete this one. So first and foremost, we'll go into settings. We're gonna enter your vehicle make and model, vehicle editor. So I got mine's in, Toyota 4Runner, VIN number, your make and model. Just do everything to the best of your knowledge. And if you don't know anything, don't change anything. And then after this, I'm gonna do a screenshot of the programs for the ATF pans. And then we'll go from there. I've been living in a bad dream. So once you add in all the values and codes that I gave you, you want to go back into dashboard. Add, go to menu, add display. Here are your choices. You could do radio or digital. Let's do radio this time. Next. Here are all the different gauges that you can set up from. I do the dark fill. Next. And then your PID. And here are the ones that you created in that settings. User PID. User defines PIDs. Go in there. And here are your pans that we created, that the codes that I gave you. Because this app didn't come with these two, so that's why I gave you the codes to add it into the programs. So I'm just like creating a program. But we'll do the ATF pan, generic, done, then done. Here you go. Drag to move, so we'll put it right there just so you know that we just created that one. And here are all the other ones I did engine temp, RPM, and miles per hour. So let's just delete this one, hold it, and remove display. Yes, ba-dow. So, sky's the limits on this. Go back, monitor. Okay. Standard vehicle is ready to mission testing. There's so much to do on this. Logs. Okay. Let's fire it up again. Play. I just hit that play. And it looks like a damn dyno sheet. I've never gotten here and to play with this, so I try not to do too much. I don't know what the hell I'm doing. It gives you your exact location, maps, diagnostic. Warning, some functions on the page. Okay. Reading codes. Confirm. No trouble codes are detected. Everything looks good.